Hey guys, Bad Infos here. As you know, on this channel I mainly do GTA 100% walkthroughs. I go into detail on how to complete the missions the most interesting, fastest and best ways. Almost a year and a half ago I completed my GTA 4 100% walkthrough, and today I decided to give you a short informational video with a 100% checklist. Here I'll discuss everything you need to know about the game, how you should start your own playthrough, I'll give you some points, tell you what you should avoid doing, what order you should do the missions in, and showcase the reward you get after 100% completion. Completing only the main story missions is not enough in order to get 100%. There are also many side missions scattered around the whole map. In my walkthrough I cover every aspect of getting 100% completion, but here I'll show you the whole list of requirements. Number 1, the main story missions. There are exactly 88 main storyline missions in the game, and you need to complete them all, starting from the Cousin's Bellic and finishing it off with either a Revenger's Tragedy or Out of Commission, depending on which ending you choose. Number 2, the random encounters. There are 14 random encounters in the game, and in order to achieve 100% completion, you need to pass over 16 missions for only 10 of the characters. They are Brian Meech, who has 3 encounters, Ryu Badman, who has 1 encounter, Mel, 1 encounter, Hossan Ramzy, 1 encounter, Ilyena Faustin has 1 encounter, Pathos has 2 encounters, Sara, again 2 encounters, Eddie Lowe, 2 encounters, Marnie Allen, 2 encounters, and finally Gracie Ancelotti, who has 1 encounter. Number 3, the friend activities. We have 5 friends in the game. For 100% we need to complete all activities available for only 3 of your friends. They are Brucie, with him you need to go boating, play bowling, go drinking, go eating, go on a heli ride, watch a show and visit a strip club. With Packy you need to play bowling, play darts, play pool, go drinking, watch a show and visit a strip club. And finally, with little Jacob you need to play darts, play pool, go drinking, go eating, watch a show and visit a strip club. Number 4, the minigames. We have 4 minigames in GTA 4. You need to win a game of pool against anybody, win a game of darts, win a full game of bowling, and finally you need to beat the high score in the cubed arcade game, which is 10,950 points. Number 5, the vehicle delivery missions. We have 2 types of vehicle deliveries in the game. They are exotic export for Brucie, where you need to steal a vehicle and deliver it to his lockup in East Hook. The vehicles are 10 and are listed on the screen. And finally, the other type of vehicle delivery mission is Stevie's car thefts, where you need to steal 30 vehicles total and bring them to his lockup in Bochum. Again, the vehicles are listed on the screen. Number 6, the Fixer assassination missions. We have 9 missions total and you need to complete them all. They are Water Hazard, Dead End, Migration Control, Derelect Target, Bailing Out for Good, Hook, Line and Sinker, Rub Down, Industrial Action, and Taken Out. Number 7, the street races. We have 9 street races in the game given to us by Brucie, and we need to win them all. They take place in South Broker, Airport, Dukes Boulevard, South Algonquin, Star Junction, Road to Bochum, North Alderney, Elevated, and South Alderney. Number 8, the drug deliveries. We have 10 drug delivery missions in the game given to us by little Jacob. They are separated into 3 different categories. There are 4 timed missions in which you have to reach a buyer quickly. We have 4 stash missions in which you need to place the drugs in a location and kill all the gang members at this spot. And lastly, we have 2 deal missions where you get ambushed and need to escape a 2-star wanted level. Number 9, the miscellaneous missions. You need to find and kill over 200 flying rats in the game. We have 22 in Broker, 28 in Dukes, 22 in Bohan, 72 in Algonquin, and 56 in Alderney City. You need to find and complete all 50 unique stun jumps in the game. We have 13 in Dukes, 4 in Bohan, 15 in Algonquin, and 18 in Alderney City. You need to kill over 30 criminals for the most wanted police mission. We have a list of 10 criminals on each major island. You need to complete a total of 20 vigilante police missions. It doesn't matter what kind you choose, you just need to complete 20. You need to reach 75% like from Brucie and unlock his chopper special ability. Similarly, you need to reach a like rating of 75 from Little Jacob and unlock his discounted guns special ability. And finally, you have to reach a like rating of 75 for Pecky to unlock his bomb special ability. And that completes the 100% checklist for GTA 4. Now I'll show you the best order of completion with no spoilers. When you start off GTA 4, you're presented with a mission right off the bat. You need to complete that first mission in order to get the ability to save the game. Now, usually when I start a new playthrough of a GTA game, I do most of the available side missions first, because they give me lots of rewards, which I can use for the main missions. GTA 4, however, is very different. Very few missions are unlocked at the beginning, the ones that are unlocked don't give you useful benefits, and you also can't safely travel to the other islands for collectibles. What you can do instead is to complete the first mission in the game and start collecting one type of each weapon on the map. These guns will be very useful in the missions ahead. Now you can continue the main storyline missions. Whenever you unlock a new friend, you can start going out with him in order to unlock his special ability. Jacob gives you cheap guns and Pecky gives you bombs. Both great for the main storyline. You can continue the main storyline and play all the way until the mission 3 Leaf closes, over which unlocks Alderney City, the last island in the game. Now, since everything is unlocked, you should start doing these side missions. Complete the following: kill 200 flying rats, collect all exotic exports, complete all 50 stun jumps, complete all vigilante and most wanted missions, and win all races for Brucie. Doing these now would give you lots of cash, so it's the perfect time to complete them. And honestly, that's pretty much it for the order. Just continue the main storyline and do the remaining side missions whenever you want to. The order in GTA 4 is really not important. Like I said, side missions are not as helpful as they are in other GTAs, so do them in any order you like. And once you have passed all the main and side missions, congratulations, you are 100% complete! The only reward for 100% game completion is that you can buy infinite ammo for your weapons. Just visit any gun shop, purchase as many bullets as you want to, and go to town! Saving and loading the game removes all the extra bullets you have acquired, so be warned. If this sounded too confusing to you guys, make sure you watch my 100% walkthrough, where I give an in-depth explanation about every single mission and activity in the game. Lastly, if you found the video useful, I encourage you to rate it accordingly and subscribe to my channel for future tutorials and walkthroughs. Thank you very much for watching, and a very special thank you goes to my lovely patrons: Alex Chavez, Enrico Torres, Scumbag Yayo, and anyone else listed here. See ya in the next one!